Hello and welcome back to Thalric Plays Mordheim, City of the Damned. We finished the first story mission of Act 2 in the last episode, successfully. And because of a lot of crits, we have some injuries to wait for. And I don't think... My memory is just horrible again. I think I've chosen these off camera, so we're going through the skills we're learning in the meantime real quick, just so that you're all up to speed. I don't really know how to spend Seraphim skill points, to be honest, and I didn't think about maybe getting her a spell this time, so we are learning knowledge more time at the moment to give her more movement range. And we can master that as well, so she should be a lot faster in the future. But aside from that, if you have good tips or ideas how I should skill her, maybe there's an active skill we could make use of, please let me know. Next up is Narondia, and she's learning Fatality at the moment. Nope, not Fatality. She's learning Vital Strike. We already learned Fatality. So that's a melee attack that deals regular damage and has a plus 10% critical hit chance. Because we are going pretty crit heavy on her with the accuracy, I think that's a good idea. Next up is Ada, who is still learning Sidestep at the moment. Yeah, we switched her against Frauke, because she's out for 5 days. And then we have Eva, who is learning Fatality. There it is. Okay, so I wasn't completely out of my mind. Maybe we should give her knowledge more time, if we can. I don't know if we will have the points for it, or the intelligence, because her movement is down thanks to the pack leg. Maybe we could get it up like that again. And I need to cough, so I'm going to pause the video real quick so you don't have to hear that. Okay, and I'm back. So, we need to advance 1 day. Or two, actually. But let's go start with one. And that leaves these. So, Seraphim will be out one more day than we want. So, we will switch her against Ludmilla, who now has the sniper shot mastered. And so we have Petra and Ludmilla in. That sounds like a really good combo, I think. And then we're going to advance one more day to get all of the injuries. And we should take a look at the hired swords real quick.
You have been rewarded.
Oh, nice. So we got a complete Mordheim's map. Two tomes of abilities. Those are really nice. I don't know who I'll put them on yet. We'll see. And then some blue stuff we don't really need, I think. Okay, let me... Nope. Still not the correct thing. We want to look at hired swords. So we have actually a rank 5 novice. If that would have been a rank 5 sister, I would have bought her immediately, because we are missing a reserve sister. But since it's not, I don't think we will buy anything from the hired swords this time. And I really want to level up Matilda and Varin, actually, but I don't feel comfortable bringing them at the moment, as long as we're still getting Kete up and running. Maybe once she hit rank 6 or 7, we'll do that, and then we'll leave Abrienda out for a few matches so that we can bring both. I think that's probably better. But we'll have to wait and see. But I do want to level them up in the near future. Maybe we'll do easier missions for that. We'll see. So let's see what we have available here. So 3 missions. What's the setup here? We do have the money. This one is okay with Brutal and Exceptional Worldstone, but I think we should send scouts because I don't really like the setup. That's not good either. A hard one. You know what? I think we can do this hard one. It's good Wordstone, which is good enough for me. Wordstone Rush, which is nice, and the setup is pretty perfect. And yeah. I was debating if I wanted to leave Abrienda out or not for this, because it's only a hard mission. But I'm not sure. Yeah, if I had Seraphim in, we could have used Seraphim and then one of the two, probably Varin, first. But since she's still learning a skill, we won't do that today. But that's probably the best. So we have our three main heroes plus one to level up. That sounds good. And maybe we'll just promote Matilda to hero. She can to leader. She can be a leader if we give her the right skill. Then we can finally get rid of Cheerwell with her megalomania. And then we could replace Kete with Matilda and so on and so forth to level them all up. Let me know what you think of that. So, at least to me at the moment, this sounds like a reasonable idea. But for now, we're going to leave everything as it is. So we'll be right back with the deployment. And here we are. Let's take a look. Okay, the map is... okay. The Wordstone placement is a bit weird. We only need to gather 6 Wordstone, so there really is not a lot. I don't know how hard it will be, and the map is tiny. It's really tiny. So we need to be careful where we set up here. Okay, we have three possible setups actually for Abrienda. They will set up down here. So I think we should orient ourselves down this path. So let's set her up there. I actually like Petra there, because I do have an idea. We'll put Ada right there and give her 4 Sigma. That way she can get over there and pick up that Wordstone pretty quickly, I hope. Other than that, we probably... yeah, let's move things down a little bit over that way. Well, we probably should leave Eva up here, but Ludmilla will go down there. Well, we can put her here, I think. Okay. Vilda down there, Kete right in the middle, Tunisa. Oh yeah, that's right, we only have one normal sister with us at the moment. And I will leave the combat lock open for now. I was thinking about maybe leaving that open. I don't know if that adds anything useful to us. It might just be aggravating when I miss real close. But I don't know, maybe. It'll help. Let me know what you think about that, please. If you like the combat lock open or not. Yeah. And now we'll start. So that's one definitely. To counter the pack leg. And she actually can only see these two? Really? So we have to move? That's unfortunate. Maybe I can wiggle into view. Yep, good enough. Maybe not the nicest thing to do, but oh well. And the last one we'll use on Kate, or probably not actually. We need to make our way down there, and I don't want Petra to lag behind too much, so let's not do that this time. And since I haven't mentioned it, we are playing against another Sisters of Sigmar warband. And that makes me a little bit nervous. Facing another maiden is not something I like to do. But it is what it is. We'll manage, I think. I hope. I assume. Okay, so the word stone is up there. All of it, though? We'll have to assume at the moment that it is. So there's at least a fragment we can see. Anything down here? Nope. So let's set ourselves up right here and then we'll climb up next turn. And apparently I'm using Ada a lot for this, I think. She's usually my novice of choice for these kinds of moves. I really don't know why. Maybe because her initiative is higher and we set her up first, so I always just choose the best placement for her to grab Wordstone that is a little bit off to the side. I don't know. Okay, and their leader is really fast. Why is that? I really need to look into the weapons and see which ones give initiative, which one take initiative and stuff like that. Maybe she's wearing a two-handed weapon? I don't know. So... yeah, we can just cut across here. And we'll have to wait and see where we find them first. Oh, she can actually, because of For Sigmar, she can get really far. It's not really of consequence yet, I think. But it might be in the next turn. And 6 Wordstone is not a lot, but we still need to make sure that we get it. And I think it's just 4 groups of 3. So all we need is one more complete Wordstone grouping for that to work out. And I'm trying to decide where they're most likely to go. They're either going to go over this way, I think, or this way, towards these Wordstone groupings. That's at least my assumption at the moment. The line of buildings here blocks view really effectively, so we'll most likely see them only when they're right on top of us, or we get to maybe we get the better setup. I don't know. We'll see. It all depends who comes through building first, probably. And that way, since we're moving most of ours down that way already, we might as well. And it's probably not worth it to go for Sigmar's Might already. And even their Impressive is faster than ours. And they are taking a little bit longer here. There's the Impressive now. And I really don't know which group I should go for. This one is a given. We are basically there. But the other ones depend a little bit on where we might see them. I don't know. It's not that easy to decide at the moment. If we don't see them early on, we might want to move down this way. Just so that we maybe get a choke points going somewhere, but if we come out here, we could be attacked from 2 sides, in theory. And I don't really like that. Maybe we can get some vision with Abrienda already. She can go pretty far. So nothing there yet. Okay, so we don't see anything here, but let's put her out right in front and center here. A little bit back so that she has... there. That could be a trap. So let's do this. Maybe if someone comes through that building, just so that we get a good charge off. And they do have an auger. And she's just insanely fast. And I assume that we should see her first. Well, depending where she runs. But it's not that unreasonable to assume. And I'm not going for Sigmar's this turn. We want to set up as best as possible. And I honestly think we don't need to go for Sigmar. Okay, at the moment the combat lock is obviously not giving anything. Because it's just turn start, turn end, ambush. But, oh well. Okay, now on the... let's see. Where does this go? Okay, that's a dead end. So that's not helpful. Maybe if we go in here... Nope, nothing to see yet, but I will put her in here, I think. I hope the door on the other side is open, so that we can maybe make a run for it and get down there next turn. That would be pretty perfect. Okay, yeah, it's all up here. That's really good. So let's see, can we set up in a way that we can gather it all? Probably not. But maybe with a little bit of wiggling. Updated. Okay, so since the Wordstone is good, I assume that in the other groups there should be at least one or two clusters.
Objectives updated.
So I really hope that we can maybe get one of those.
Updated.
Not that we are too picky when the optional objective is Wordstone Rush, but if I can get more Wordstone out of it, I'll obviously won't say no. We didn't gain any vision going that way, so... Oh, is that new? The strategy points can be seen on the map? I never noticed that before. And I should have checked the negative warp effects that we've gotten, but I assume they will be gone before we make any contact with her. And if they ran where I assume they would go, they might come through the buildings this turn already. Probably next turn. But we might be able to see one of them with a little bit of luck. Depends on how aggressive they go for it or not. Sometimes it's a bit hard for me to discern what the AI is up to, because it sometimes really makes some erratic choices that are not easy to understand. Okay, nice. Gift of Savagery. So it would be perfect if we wouldn't have to waste that. Can we see something? And I am splitting up a little bit at the moment, of course. But I think we're still close enough together that this shouldn't be too big of a problem. We need to be a little bit careful with the fence here, because it's not broken, so we need to run around it every time. And we can't really set up Ludmilla yet, because we don't know where they will come from. So that's a bit of a bummer. Let's see, if we run her up here, maybe we gain some vision. We don't, so let's scavenge here. Yeah, why not? It's at least worth some money. And let's set her up right here and go for an overwatch. It's a good thing that we don't see them yet over here, so I assume they are going that way. But if someone comes into view here, she should have a line of sight and be able to take a shot. But I like that knowledge that they are not apparently coming that way. That is really helpful. I don't really understand why they're behaving like they do, but oh well, it is what it is. Okay. So they have three more actions, or three more units. And I don't know if I've played on this map before, this specific one. They are all pretty similar, at least the ones that are thematically in one group, which makes sense, of course, but that also means that it's a little bit hard to discern sometimes which maps I've already played on. But I assume we've played on almost all of them by now. But this one is really small compared to others, I feel like. Yeah, let's move her around there as well. If they are really coming from that direction, these two are at least in a good position to maybe intercept someone. And I'm not sure where I want to go with Abrienda. We might be able to make our way down there with her. And I should at least take a look if we can get out here. Yes, we can. Do we see someone? We do not. So can I get that wordstone there? We can. And it's two shards and a cluster. So I'm liking this a lot.
Objectives updated.
And it should be pretty safe on Abrienda. And what did we get? Plus one OP cost to shoot and aim. We don't care about that. Nothing.
Objective completed.
And another positive and negative. Okay, yeah. More shoot and aim, which we don't really care about. Okay, we don't want to be out in the open completely, though, so let's put her right here so that they don't see me. If everything goes according to my plan.
A new round has started.
Oh, we did spot someone there in the end. That's okay, actually, but they went where I assumed they would go, and we're in an okay position. Okay, so there's an ambush inside the building. And do we want to trigger that yet? I think probably not. Mainly because we don't really know in which building. Well, that one, apparently. But I don't know. Where are they? Okay, so they're over there all the way still. So we probably should just set up an ambush right here. It's a pretty aggressive move, but I like it. And we can circle around with the two novices over there. And everyone else should be able to catch up. Oh, she stayed just out of our reach. That's too bad. Okay, Ada just needs to run down this way. Yep, but we should put her into this courtyard, I think, and keep her. Let's put her down in this, under this, yep, can't think of the right word. Narondia, okay. Do we actually want to gather more wordstone over there? That would be a bit of a stretch, I think. So let's pull her back and not do that. We do have enough wordstone for the optional objective. Oh boy. So we triggered that again. That shouldn't be too big of a deal at the moment, I hope. Let's just set her up right here and go for an ambush. We want to wait for them here and maybe catch them off guard in the doorway and not fight inside buildings if we can avoid it. So yeah, we will going to take it slow. Well, as slow as the AI allows us to take it, because they are really close already. And one of them should try to engage us, I hope. Okay, Eva. Where do we want to go with Eva? Let's just put her right here. And ambush? Or do we want to maybe go for a dodge right out in the open here? Or a sidestep? Because... yeah, why not? Let's try that. Maybe we can use her as a little bit of bait. Ludmilla won't see anything from up there, and we know where they are coming from now. So I'm going... oh. We already have a sniper shot. So we are going to take that. Yep. And we have a really decent chance of critting, actually. Okay, didn't happen, but... it's fine. One reload. And... yeah, thanks to the cover... things are not that easy to hit. But we might as well try. I don't know if an Overwatch would be better. It would most likely be affected by cover as well, so... I don't think it's that big of a deal. But at least we got a first hit in, and that's really good. And I think we might want to put her up there if we can in the long run. Oh, please tell me we trigger. Thank you. Oh, nice hit. And a counterattack. Yep. Oh, 90%. Okay, but we did finally make contact, so we can start attacking them. And I actually like this point of engagement here. We should be able to limit their access pretty good, I think. They might come through buildings, of course, but I think we should be fine here. And maybe we don't want to engage her, but move on the other one there. But let's just keep her like. Let's just put her on here. We can go for a kidney strike. Yep, that's really nice. And then we'll end our turn. And Keita really can't get anywhere yet. We do want her to be able to parry. Okay, yeah, that won't help, so let's put her as far away as we can while still being able to give Petra the Sigmar's Might buff. A little bit closer. There it is. And we are getting to a point where we can actively use her in combat. But I'm not feeling completely comfortable yet with it. So we are not engaging right away, although we could have, probably. And let's see. Maybe the Maiden will show up. And I think the Maiden is probably the only impressive that shouldn't get stuck ever, at least... not in the way the other big ones get stuck. And we did see her. Okay, yeah, she's there. So we will see her very soon, probably. But this makes the placement of Tunisa really good, because otherwise engaging her would have been a little bit more problematic with the way we would have to run. But if we're lucky, we will be able to take her down this turn. Okay, yeah, let's just move Abrienda back through this building. And I'm really surprised still no one has snatched up Abrienda for with her name, because it's the Impressive. She's... why? Don't you want your name on the Impressive? let's just ambush right here. Probably won't matter too much.
A new round has started.
Okay, so there's the Augur, but she... well, she can engage us here. But it... oh, nice, she's actually coming right out into the open. I don't have a problem with that. We can work with it. And she gets a lot of attacks. And... it's one. So maybe we want to loot her. I will take the Sigmarite Warhammer, and we don't really need the room, so we might as well do this. And let's just block their approach through this building with Petra for now. Because if we attack here, she should be the only one that is able to engage there. And I think I'd rather sidestep than insult this turn. So let's go for two normal attacks. I don't know, maybe they can fit a second one on there. I really hope they can't, but they might be able to. If they are, we will disengage. But first, they need to hit me. That's one dodge. And that's a miss, so we still have one dodge. So she missed her precise strike. That sounds about right. Narondia. I don't really want to engage with her. We want that space for others to be open. Namely, Abrienda. But I don't know, maybe she's a good choice here. It should be fine, I hope. Let's see, maybe we can sneak around here. Oh yes, we can, that's perfect. So that worked out. One quick incision, and let's go for a vital strike as well. So, what's next? Ada. Well, we can just move her out right into the open now. Oh boy. I keep reacting poorly to those. we just about can't reach, so let's keep her back here and ambush. That way we should be able to avoid an engagement on the novices over there if someone comes through those buildings. And we still have Tunisa that will be able to give assists if someone comes through one of these doorways. And she should be pretty much blocking there. I think they can actually fit a second one in here, and I'm really nervous that they're going to put their Impressive here. I don't want that. And we will have to take out quite a lot of them, because they also started with 200 morale. So it will take a lot of work to whittle them down. But so far, everything looks fine, I think. And we're making some good progress here. And I hope that my choice of the Rune of Misfortune pays off soon. Because we really want to crit them. And that should show up here, shouldn't it? Yeah, if I could actually see. So, half, quarter to half cover, we can get rid of that. Can we get rid of that without? Yep, nice. So we should still do, probably still do a sniper shot, I think. I really want to see that crit now. With the mastery, it should deal a lot of damage. Okay, let's aim that. It's probably better. Okay, really nice chances there. And turn. What it's nice to know, because I didn't know that, that the critical hit chance and the normal hit chance are separate rolls. I know that some games handle that differently, where you have a hit range, and if you hit especially low, so in your crit range, you automatically crit. And it looks like that Mordheim doesn't do it like this, which is fine. This looks promising, so we should... Well, we can engage here, I think. And then we'll Sigmar's Might. Oh yes, that looks real beautiful. Rebuke is not so bad, but that means we won't be casting anymore, but maybe we can take her down. We do get two more attacks. So all we need is one more hit. A crit would have been nice, but now it doesn't really matter anymore, but that's really good. Every enemy that Kata's taking out, I'm really happy about. And I'm even more happy about that. Rune of Perseverance. On attack missed, plus 5% hit chance for next action. That's not bad. That's actually really nice. And a Dagger of Expertise. Plus 3% melee hit chance. Also not bad. And I was thinking about just maybe equipping Ada with the daggers. So maybe we'll give her that one. We'll see. And now we will retreat with her again and just parry. So this is a really decent start right now. I'm still a bit concerned about their impressive and where it might come from, because it's right there. I don't know. This is not something I want to deal with necessarily. Let's set up an ambush here. We don't want to engage. If the impressive comes through that doorway, we don't want to ambush it inside the doorway, especially with the sister, who can only parry. Well, against the sister, the maiden, actually parry would work, but still. I want to get as many sisters on her as I can. And I think it's fairly likely that she will come through that. Nope. She's... Okay, I was talking about getting stuck, didn't I? So she got stuck on that doorframe. Really? Okay, so... Oh, nice. Maybe we want to move through this room? Let's see. So, we don't see anyone else. We took down 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So there's 3 more out there, probably, I don't know where. The question is, do I want to move around here or not? Because their impressive is right there, but we do need a target for our impressive as well. So maybe we'll move over this way and trigger their impressive, or we just engage on her over there. I don't know. Let's keep her back for this turn. Or maybe we'll just put her... Yeah, we can go for the scavenge point, why not? Oh, 57 gold crowns. That works. And then we'll just ambush right here. That should allow us to get one more on there if someone comes through here. And as much as I don't want to waste Ambrienda, I don't think we should attack with her. We should let them come towards us, as much as I don't really want to. So yeah, let's just... Or maybe what we might be able to do is cast Sinful Speech on their leader first. That way we're at least making a little bit of use of her skill set. And I actually don't want to cast that on the Maiden if she decides to attack us more instead of... if she decides to cast instead of attacking us, that's fine with me. She just deals so much damage. So that's the second dodge, and now we get hit. And what I will do is attack twice, I think, with Petra. And then we'll disengage. So let's just... Okay, we can't disengage. That's unfortunate, so I should have insulted her first. You only have one eye. And then we'll sidestep again. So this is a bit of a problem. Maybe. We'll see. Let's delay. We actually do have an option here, I think. Okay, hold ground. What else? Okay, she can engage on Petra. That's what I was afraid of. And then stuff like this happens. Oh, nope. I don't like this. Okay, we need to move through there. There's just no question about it anymore. That was really bad for me. Oh boy. Yep, so we're going to move down there. Let's see. Okay, there's their impressive. And there's the wordstone. So actually, let's set up right here. And ambush. We'll pick that up if we can next turn, and if not, then not. But yeah, this is really unfortunate at the moment. And actually, she can get closer. And I just want to keep an open space here so that everyone else can move through if we need them to. And maybe we want to engage their impressive now. Can I charge? Can I not get a charge off there? Okay, that way we can engage on her, but that would probably be the... Oh boy, I don't really like this. But it's probably better than just leaving her to do whatever she wants. I don't know. This is not a decision I want to make at the moment. But we need to. The problem is these two are up next and they will come this way. And they will attack Eva as well. So, you know what? Let's not do that. We'll ambush right here. I don't know if that's better, but it at least should prevent some of the initial damage. And hopefully Ludmilla can help Petra. Ideally, we want to have 3 movement points left. So that would be on the leader. Can we not get vision on the other one? Okay, apparently I can only see the leader, and because of that we're going to do it like this, even though it's a hard... Nope, that way it's really good. Let's try. Maybe we can get a crit on her. Thank you. Did that stun? I don't know. We'll see soon. I hope that stunned her. And that was a lot of damage. Okay, Keita. She should be in. Nope, that was no stun. Okay, what are my options here? I think what I will do, even though it's 50-50, we probably should try one healing circle here to help Petra a little bit. Okay, that worked. I don't know, probably no Sigmar's Might though, so let's move her through this way. And let's put ourselves right here and parry. She probably will be attacked. At least I assume that it will happen. But we'll see. And then we'll move Vilda through here. And ambush. And now things will get interesting, because those are the three we need to worry about. These two and her. Oh, they're impressive, only has one arm. I did not notice that before. And she's casting. That's what we want. We don't want her attacking. We want her casting. And because she has only one arm, she's actually not dealing that much damage. That could work in our favor. She still gets a lot of attacks. That's a bit of a problem. But it probably could be worse, in all honesty. So do we want to engage with Tanisa? Probably. The question is, do I want to be able to dodge afterwards? Yes, but the charge is horrible, and we want to have two attacks. And we did hit one, so that's okay. And we actually hit two, that's really good. Considering the percentages we had there. Let's see who she goes on to. Okay, she charges Eva, that's not nice. And she blocks access to to the other one there, or to the impressive. So we want to get rid of her as fast as possible. But we can actually put Abrienda on their impressive, so we should do that. She's just deals too much damage. And can soak up the most as well. And I really hope that those quick incisions, yep, there it is, will earn their keep. Nice. So that helps a lot.
A new round.
And Petra is actually our biggest concern right now, and I think she... Oh boy, she's got crit. She's not down yet, but we can't disengage, so we are in a bit of trouble. All alone. And there it is. Okay. Yep, Petra's down. That's... I made a mistake there. But I think we can actually afford to pick those up. I really hope that Petra will be okay. And that was really unfortunate to happen. I don't like that. Oh, nice, I rolled a 100 there. Okay, I actually don't really need the combat log. Personally, for me, it doesn't add too much. It's nice to see the percentages sometimes, but it's not that informative for me. So I'm going to leave it on for this match, maybe the next one. And please let me know what you think of it, if you want to keep it in there, or if I should just deactivate it, or even if you don't care at all, please let me know anyways. Every little bit of information helps me there. And I don't know if she took a stance. Probably. Or maybe not. Either way, it's not the problem to go for the normal attack first and then the vital strike. And that's it. Okay, Ada. And we'll just add on there. And with her, I actually should have charged. She should get a skill with an active skill in the end as well, I think. But not yet. I don't think she has the skill points at the moment. And can the leader actually go somewhere meaningful? Apparently not. She's just staying there. Oh, hello. There's their Sister Superior. Can she reach? Nope. But that's almost all of them. I don't know why that one down there. Maybe, she's probably up next. Come on. Maybe we can get another crit? No, we should still focus on the impressive. Even with her, even with stun recovery, she will still be able to deal a lot of damage. Okay, and Ludmilla is actually in a really dangerous situation, but she also has a good chance of taking out that annoying one there. That's okay. 60% though, with an aim it would be better, but an aim is not what I want, or do I? No, not really. On the leader would be safer, that's definitely the case. Okay. And we actually did manage that without... Okay, that doesn't look right, but oh well. Let's see. That's one. And those shots are just horrible, but maybe I can get that a little bit better? Apparently not. Let's see, we have a 25% chance to kill her. Please? Thank you. That was really lucky. I don't have trouble admitting that, and let's hide. But that is certainly helpful to get her down. Okay. Let's see here. I mean, it's pretty obvious who we want to go on. And hopefully she'll fail her all alone test. It was really unnecessary that we lost Petra there. And I'm a bit annoyed that it happened. It's not like we can change anything, but still. That was really unnecessary. And I'm just going to use Cater for buffing again, but yeah, not quite. I don't think if we can get any closer than that to get the last remaining novice in there as well. So we're not going to. And nope, 45% wrath chance is not something I want to deal with. Where is the sister in ambush there? We don't care. Let's hide back here. And now we get to see what they do next. Or not. That's the last one we hadn't seen. Okay, stun recovery, and she's taking her attacks. Let's see. Oh, wow. But we resisted the stun. That's really nice. There we do, don't. Wow. Why is she kidding? What? Is the AI trying to tell me something? I crit you, you crit me, whatever. That was weird. That was a lot of damage. And that will give us a lot of open wounds again, and we might actually lose one more if we're not careful. So at least she's not doing anything. Oh, come on, really? We should be able to take her down. Thank you. And hopefully we can fit through that doorway. Because I would really like to attack their leader. And looks like we can. But I would also like to loot here, but we just can't get anywhere where we are possible, where we are physically able to. So that's not going to happen, unfortunately. Maybe her weapon would have been good. And I can't get around to loot Eva's stuff. Petra's stuff. And that's also a little bit unfortunate. Well, let's just attack her. That way we do at least lock her down. And I'm not too afraid of her damage. But that maiden really went nuts on us there in the with her last actions. That was a bit unnecessary. More. Oh, she does have armor break though. It's still not that much damage, luckily, but I don't know. She does have at least something. And wow, another crit. With the amount of attacks is not that unlikely, but still. And I'm really happy that we resisted the stun again. Yeah, she should be coming here now. But against Vilda, it's not a big deal. Yep, thank you. Ow. Yeah, we need to heal here. Because two of ours are really close to getting down. What does their morale look like? They are getting close to routing. So at least there's that. Sniper shot. Yeah, this mission didn't go as well as I had hoped, but as long as no one else goes down, it's still okay, I think. That was one stupid mistake I shouldn't have made, and it was really unfortunate that we weren't able to disengage there. It looked like we should have been able to, but because we were at an angle inside the doorway, we couldn't. Yeah, I don't think we were blocking us from behind. So we just have to hope that nothing bad happens to Petra. Okay, she's not getting there. Oh, that's actually really lucky. Mm-hmm. Yeah, let's take her. Oh, come on. Always when I say let's just take her down, something like this happens. And then we don't take her down. So I looked like an idiot. So thanks for that. Oh, yep. I needed to hit that, apparently. I mean, raged resistance is of no interest to us, but still. So let's go for a healing circle and heal the little bit that it does. We really need to get more spell points so that we can master that. Okay, that wasn't nice. I don't know what that does. And I probably should not go for Sigmar's Might, but take her down to get more experience on Kate. Or we actually can just do both. So that's good. But that's worse. So what just happened? I think everyone just got open wounds? Maybe? Kate has open wounds now, and she wasn't injured before, so yep, apparently that happened. So these will all be... We will be... Have to skip two more days. I don't like this. Oh, there's the last one. We'll see if she's of any consequence. They are really close to routing. Oh, Gift of Savagery, but that will stop her movement, okay. I think it's actually been quite some time since we've seen everyone from the enemy warband. I don't know if that's a good idea here or not, but I still want to do this. Because the leader is almost down. And if we can force them to rout, and we still have sidestep, so we should be okay. Yeah, she's down, so everything should work out fine. Let's take a quick look. Look at the loot. And that's really nice. Oh, 5%. Oh, cool. Shield of health. We might as well take the sticky sludge. And I really don't know if that helps or not, but I will take Petra's Holy Tome. I think Scott Smart said something like this, that it might help with the aftermath. I don't know if that's true or not. I don't know if it's covered in tutorials or anywhere. But let's just assume that it is. So, yeah. That we can just hope that it works. And oh boy, we need to go around. And if she makes a full recovery, I will totally put it on that. And for everyone who's confused who Scott Smart is, he's one of my viewers, and he basically comments on every Mordheim video, what I really, really like, and it's just awesome, so yeah.
A new round has started.
What else? So they need to rout, hopefully. If not, the... Sister Superior here will attack us, assuming she doesn't fail her all alone test. But that's a lot of ifs, so let's just see what happens here. They succeed their route test, because sisters. She succeeds her all alone check, because sisters. And I forgot what Sign of Sigmar does, but since we're dodging right now, I don't really care too much. And then she misses. She probably has only two attacks. Nope, there's the third one. Yeah, she's ranked 10, so of course she has 3 attacks. Uh-huh. And then we can do one more. And let's just hope that we can take her down before anyone else of them can take an action. Because then we will have, they will have to check again. And that would be the ideal scenario right now. But I don't know if it's possible. It depends if we can maybe get the kill with Ludmilla. She should be able to get line of sight. Okay, she's apparently too close. That's weird. Can I... Oh boy, I triggered the ambush. That was smart. Yeah, that was not smart. But maybe we can put ourselves on that little thing. Nope. Oh yes, wow. Okay, I ran past it twice and third time it worked. Holy crap, her debuffs. That's a little bit. And I'm still not critting. I'm calling Hex. And we didn't take her down, just barely, so the one that just ambushed us does get her attacks off, I think. Nope, it's that one. Which might actually be worse, because she's closer to... What? Why? I don't get that, in all honesty. I mean, I once again won't complain, but I don't get that. Yeah, we need to move right here and go for the healing circle to get the best effect out of it. And then we'll just move her against her, because that way she will at least have to check for all alone. I at least assume that she will. I don't know if Ludmilla counts with her rifle. She's still engaged to two enemies, so that might... I don't know how that works. We will see. Maybe. She might just go down now and they might get their check again. Oh, please tell me I can loot her. Thank you. Because I do want that hammer. Plus 10% Overwatch damage, because that's important. But plus 10% ambush damage is actually not that bad. But still, it looks weird. Let's go here. So. Now they fail. Okay, nice. So only one went down. We do get a lot of open wounds, though, which is a bit unfortunate. We get an unknown formula as well, and also two more clusters. So three clusters, seven shards, two fragments. That's nice. And I hope one or two rank ups. Maybe. We did get the optional objective, and Kate took down quite two,
are the triumphant,
I think.
For in them shines the glory of Sigmar.
Maybe that will be enough to get her to the next rank. So let's see. Once this has finished loading, there it is. Yep, light wounds. Oh, just barely missed it. 9, and we needed 10. Oh no. Oh crap. There it is. So Petra is dead. No. I'm sorry, Shank. I'm so sorry. I killed her. Nah, crap. Okay. Not what I was hoping for.
Another one bites the dust.
I mean, it was bound to happen eventually. But still. Yeah, and we got a lot of...
Nice program.
A lot of light wounds. Because of that wrath. And
nice
all those crits.
Progress.
But we did rank up again. And we acquired a lot of stuff. And now we have a formula of scouts. Yeah, that's just horrible. Really horrible. Pay treatment and pay upkeep. So we need to check our hired swords. Maybe we could buy her as a replacement, and we probably will, because she doesn't cost us anything and she's rank 4 already. We got her as a reward from one of the story missions, I think. So let's do that. Yep. Okay. And enlist her. Continue. And I'm actually thinking about changing the way we use the Sister Superior to one hand and shield instead of a two-hander. Just because I think she would be very well suited to that, so we will skill her with that in mind now. So what we are going to go for first is some strength. And here we will go all the way weapon skill for now. We do want some leadership. And then some... Yeah, let's go with intelligence for now. So apply those changes. And then we have 8 unspent skill points. That we need to spend right now. The big question is, on what do we want to spend those? What does this actually do? Okay, increase melee resistance. Okay, since we are going for shield, we will just go with Web of Steel right away. And I could just master it. That actually looks like a good idea. Yeah, why not? It would take 5 days otherwise. Oh no, we can't. We need more weapon skill, which we can't get yet, so that's not an option. But then let's go for some passive skills. There are some obvious ones, of course. The ones I'm always going for, which are these. But let's see. Counterattacks. Yeah, we should probably go for shield specialist. If we use a shield on her, that's actually really good. The increased melee resistance. Oh, you know what? What we definitely need with her, because we will put her in heavy armor. We need armor proficient. We can't master that yet, unfortunately, but still, I'm happy with that. Then we'll take shield specialist. Now we don't have the skills to master that anymore, so we need one more. I think we might just go with Demoralize again. Or maybe... I don't know how much we will go into accuracy. Probably enough, but I don't know if it's enough for the big quick incision. But it probably will be, I think. So let's go with that one. It wasn't the most cost-effective choices here, of course. I could have maybe chosen skills that cost more money, even when you usually learn them, but I'm fine with this choice, so that's perfectly okay with me. So that should be it. We'll free the training for this warrior, and remaining points we'll need to spend at normal cost. We don't have skill points anymore, and we don't have normal points anymore, so we confirm that. And then we'll also need to change her preset. We just need to find the right one. That's the one. And I will just name her Petra von Schenk again for now. If you want another warrior now that the original Petra has died, or maybe we'll name her Petra von Schenk. Come on. The second. So that probably should be with a point at the end, I think. I don't know. We'll just leave it like that. And Schenk, please let me know what you think and what you want to hear. So, but we are going to put you in heavy armor. We might as well use this heavy armor of toughness. Then you're going to get... Yeah, let's give you this pendant. I don't think a helmet would help too much. That little bit of armor absorption is not... The stun resistance would be nice, but... This one is really good as well. And then we'll need you in a... with a one-handed weapon. Critical hit resistance... Great flail is not something we need. So we actually have this hammer. I think we're going to go with this flail. And do we have a decent shield already of health? Wordstone resistance, poison resistance, critical resistance, unsuccessful parry, 15% chance to gain 1 OP. That's actually good, so let's take that one. Okay, so that's the new Petra. It's still really unfortunate what happened there. And before we end this, let me take a look. Do we have... Because we need to skip more days here again, so maybe we can get the skill on Ludmilla in the meantime. That actually probably isn't the worst idea we ever had. So let's do that. Let's master Eagle Eye. I think armor absorption bypass increased to 10. Makes sense to me. And who else? Matilda. Maybe we just want to promote her to hero, but I actually don't want to commit to that yet. So I don't know. We'll keep things as they are right now. So let's advance 2 more days. And we did get a decent amount of Wordstone out of that. And I'm actually waiting to see the next story mission pop up here. Okay, they all have recovered now, except for Ludmilla, who is learning her skills. So we will switch Ludmilla against Seraphim. And I think it's actually more important to get Petra back up to fighting strength before we put our attention to Varin and Matilda, so we'll leave it like this for the time being. We'll see, maybe we'll have to do some more easier missions to get everyone back to a better range again. She should be pretty sturdy already, even though her hit points aren't that high. Maybe we should just put purple armor on her. That's probably it, and I'm going to do that right now, I think. Is Wilda wearing... No, she's wearing blue armor. What about Frauke? Frauke's wearing blue armor as well. So who's got the purple one? Abrienda, most likely. That's 45 instead of 35. Yeah, let's switch those. And let's enchant that real quick. And what do we want to go with here? That doesn't help too much. Accuracy and toughness doesn't sound too bad. Plus 2 strength is okay, but we're already at a really high strength. So I think we're going to take accuracy and toughness. I like this. Okay, and I think that's where we're going to end the episode for today. I'll just put the armor on in a moment. So thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed this one. If you did, please leave a like and a comment. And if you want to see me play Mordheim, just subscribe if you haven't already. And as always, thanks for watching. I hope that you tune in next time and have a nice day. Bye.